We start with an important topic in calculus, which is derivatives, that is differentiation. Dear students, in our day-to-day life, we always face the questions such as, how does the patient respond with respect to the given dose? How does the profit change with respect to manufacturing cost of the product? What is the rate of change of pressure of a gas with respect to its volume? How does the length of a metal rod change with respect to change in temperature? Or what is the rate of change of velocity with respect to time? All these questions are related with rate of change of one varying quantity with respect to the corresponding change in other. Such a rate measure is called as derivative. This is actually the physical significance of derivative. The geometrical interpretation of derivative is, it gives the slope of tangent to the curve at a point on the curve. Now we will discuss the definition of derivative. If x and x plus h belong to the domain of the same function f, and if limit f of x plus h minus fx upon h as h tends to 0 exists, it is called as derivative of the function f at x and is denoted by f dash of x. Finding the derivative of given function by using the above definition is called finding the derivative from the first principles. The limit f of a plus h minus f of a upon h as h tends to 0, if it exists, is called as derivative of f at x equal to a and is denoted by f dash of a. If f is differentiable at x equal to a, then it is continuous at x equal to a, but the converse is not true. Now, using this definition, we can obtain derivatives of standard functions. The list is given below. If the function is x raised to n, what is its derivative? Its derivative is nx raised to n minus 1. Remember, base is a variable and index is a constant. Now, how to remember this result? It is index into x raised to index minus 1. Now, the function root x is of this type only. You should remember that derivative of root x is what? 1 upon 2 root x. Now, how to find this? As I said, using above formula. Because root x is x raised to half, so its derivative will be half x raised to half minus 1, that is half into x raised to minus half, which is nothing but 1 upon 2 root x. Derivative of any constant is 0. How to remember this? As I said, derivative measures the rate of change. Constant is 1 which does not change, so it will be the derivative of constant, obviously it will be 0. What is derivative of 1 upon x? Some students say derivative of 1 upon x is 1 because derivative of x is 1. That is not correct, because you have to bring function 1 upon x in standard form, that is x raised to n. So what is 1 upon x? It is x raised to minus 1, so its derivative will be minus 1 into x raised to minus 1 minus 1. That is minus 1 upon x square. What is derivative of sin x? It is cos x. What is derivative of cos x? It is nothing but minus sin x. Derivative of tan x with respect to x is sec square x. Derivative of cot x is minus cosec square x. Derivative of sec x is sec x tan x. Derivative of cosec x is minus cosec x cot x. Derivative of e raised to x is e raised to x. This is the only function whose derivative is the same as that function. What is derivative of a raised to x? It is a raised to x log a. In fact, this is the original result, because when I say a raised to x, by that I mean a is greater than 0, not equal to 1. What is e? You should know that e is an irrational number. 2 less than e less than 3. The approximate value is 2.718281. E is taken as base of logarithm in calculus. See, in calculus, you have to remember two things. The first is base of logarithm is e. If it is not e, you have to change the base to e. using change of base formula. And secondly, the angle must be in radian. If it is in degrees, you have to convert it into radians. So derivative of a raised to x is a raised to x log a. So derivative of e raised to x will be e raised to x log e, but log e is 1, as base of logarithm is e in calculus, and logarithm of any number to the same base, of course it should be valid, is always 1. Next function is log x, an important one. What is derivative of log x? Derivative of log x is 1 upon x. Then inverse functions. What is derivative of sine inverse x? Derivative of sine inverse x is 1 upon root 1 minus x square. What is derivative of cos inverse x? It is minus 1 upon root 1 minus x square. Derivative of tan inverse x is 1 upon 1 plus x square. Derivative of cot inverse x is minus 1 upon 1 plus x square. Derivative of sec inverse x is 1 upon x into root of x square minus 1. What is the derivative of cosec inverse x? It is minus 1 upon x into root of x square minus 1. Now let us discuss the rules of differentiation. Suppose y, u, v, w are differentiable functions of x. What do you mean by differentiable function? If derivative of a function exists, it is called as differentiable or derivable function. The first rule is, if y equal to u plus v, then what is dy dx? It is du dx plus dv dx. That is, derivative of sum is sum of derivatives. Simple rule. Same is for difference. What will be the derivative of difference? It is difference of derivatives. The second rule is important. Product rule. Now don't say that derivative of product is product of derivatives. See whether you can understand this or not. If I make a statement, if derivative of product is product of derivatives, derivative of each function will be zero. I'll explain how. Consider the function sine x. I can write sine x as 1 into sine x. If derivative of product were the product of derivatives, the answer would have been derivative of 1 into sine x is derivative of 1, which is 0, into derivative of sine x, which is cos x. So finally the answer is 0. So derivative of product, remember, is not product of derivatives. Then what is that rule? The product rule is, if y is uv, that is u into v, then dy dx is u dv dx plus v du dx. That is, derivative of product is not product of derivatives. It is first function into derivative of second plus second function into derivative of first. What are the corollaries of this rule? The first is, if y is k into u, where k is a constant, then clearly dy dx is k into du dx, where k is a constant. For example, what is derivative of 3 sine x? It is 3 into derivative of sine x, which is nothing but 3 into cos x. So final answer is 3 cos x. Second corollary, if y is uvw, that is product of 3 functions. In fact, I can consider uvw as uv into w. So I can treat uv as the first function and w as the second function. So this rule can be applied to product of number of functions. So in this case, if y is uvw, then what is dy dx? It is uv into dw dx plus uw into dv dx plus uw into du dx. Or you can take uvw common to get in bracket, 1 upon u du dx plus 1 upon v dv dx plus 1 upon w dw dx. The next rule is an important one. It is called as quotient rule. If y is u upon v, then what is dy dx? It is v du dx minus u dv dx upon v square. Now that should be actually v not equal to 0. Remember, in mathematics, there are two important things. Number one, denominator should not be 0. That is, you should not divide by 0. Secondly, root of negative number is not real. Up to 10th standard, you used to say root of negative number is not defined. But now square root of a negative number is defined. You know that root of minus 1 is I, an imaginary unit, but clearly it is not real. Now how to remember the quotient rule? See, it is u upon v, so u appears first, that is in the numerator, so it will be differentiated first. So what is derivative of quotient? It is denominator into derivative of numerator minus numerator into derivative of denominator upon denominator square, provided denominator is not equal to 0. Now we start with an important rule. In fact, derivative starts with this particular type, this definition. It is called as chain rule, that is derivative of composite function. Actually, before you start doing calculus, few required things are: you should have knowledge of trigonometry, you should have knowledge of logarithm, and the most important topic is functions. So chain rule is regarding derivative of composite function. What do you mean by a composite function? Function of a function is called as composite function. So if y is a function of u and u is a function of x, then what is dy dx? It is dy du into du dx. This is in fact chain of derivatives. So it can continue like this. If y is a function of u, u is a function of v, v is a function of w, and finally w is a function of x, then what is dy dx? It is dy du into du dv into dv dx into dw dx. Before that, I should tell you that dy dx is very important notation for derivative. It was suggested by the German mathematician Leibniz. So it is called as Leibniz notation. Actually, initially we used to say if y is sine x, then derivative of sine x with respect to x is cos x. Now we need not say like that. We can just say ddx of sine x is nothing but cos x, right? So similarly, what is ddt of sine t? It is nothing but cos t, and so on. Now we will discuss few sums. The first one, what is derivative of root x plus 1 upon root x raised to 5? Clearly, the base is a variable and index is a constant. So we say that treat base as u. So function becomes y equal to u raised to 5. So what is dy dx in this case? It is phi u raised to 5 minus 1, that is 4, into ddx of u. We have taken u for what? Root x plus 1 upon root x. Now derivative of root x is 1 upon 2 root x, and derivative of 1 upon root x, for that I write 1 upon root x as x raised to minus half. So what is derivative of x raised to minus half? It is minus half into x raised to minus half minus 1. So on simplification, you get the final answer on the screen.